35 Reasons Why Alien is an Awesome Horror Porn Birth Death Movie. I've outlined before in my straight-faced analysis videos that Alien plays on the audience's subconscious sexual fears and our deep desire to return to the comfort and security of the womb. The whole f***ing film is packed with details communicating those themes and more. Here's 35 examples. Number 1, the alien's head is a giant c***. Don't believe me? Check out Giga's conceptual designs. See this? That's what the women in the movie are afraid of. Number 2, the central computer on the Nostromo ship is called Mother, and only a motherfucker could miss the symbolism there.
Morning, Mother.
Number 3, the crew communicate with Mother in a fleshy spherical room with a vaginal door for an exit. Ridley Scott used to call this set the womb room. Number 4, see this acid-proof pen? Parker invented that. Number 5, wait a minute, if the whole f***ing Nostromo ship is like the organic body of a woman, and the crew are all like babies, all comfy and cosy inside, and are afraid of the cold and hostile universe outside, then does that explain why everybody looks so tired and sleepy so often? Is that why it's so hot and everyone's all sweaty? Is that why there's so much dripping water and condensation, and dirt and dark tunnels, and fleshy looking set designs with vaginal doors? And what are these things, are they breasts or X-acts or what? Number 6, when Ripley finds out that the company has ordered the alien to be returned alive and that the crew are expendable, we see the words Science Officer Eyes Only displayed on her face before they even appear on the computer screen. Not only is that unrealistic, being that screens disperse light evenly in all directions to be readable at any angle, but they're even written the right f***ing way around on her face so as to be readable to us. Number 7, lots of people have noticed all the porn pin-up imagery when Ripley is nearly chicken-choked with a porn mag by Ash. But how many of you ever noticed a picture of fried eggs? Eggs, motherfucker, eggs. Number 8.
Now it's time for ice cream. Or maybe some nuts. Cool glass of orange. Why not try a hot dog?
Number 9. See the way the words on Mother's screen don't just appear normally? They're fired on screen by lasers. F-choof, f-choof. When I take out trolls in the comments section, I want my words to appear like that. F-choof, f-choof. Number 10. The fear of rape by male characters is a subtle theme. Parker makes a naughty comment to Lambert over dinner, and he reads a porno mag here. And the alien sticks its f***ing tail up between Lambert's legs before it kills her. Any morons who think that's overanalysis only need to look at the hard-on metaphor in the cocktail deleted scene. And when I say cocktail, I'm not talking Tom Cruise, and I'm not talking Ted Tail either. And the film isn't being racist toward Parker either. Ash does the chicken choke shuffle, and judging by the pictures of a young white guy on the opposite wall to the porn pinups, this must be Dallas's or Kane's bunk. So basically, all the guys are horny bastards. Number 11, the computer at the beginning of the film farts and wakes up all the sleeping babies. Number 12, see this thing here aimed at Dallas and Ash? That's a c***. Number 13, see this awesome little yellow light here in the corner? How did we not notice it before? Number 14, in the DVD commentary, Ridley Scott admitted to choosing this design for the vent doors so he could make it look like a predatory alien eye. But my first thoughts were, what an arsehole. Number 15, see these pecking birds on the table? Fuck, awesome. Number 16, when H.R. Giga originally designed the alien egg prop, it was only a one-way slit. But because it was too obviously vaginal and might offend Catholics, he turned it into a Christian cross section to doubly offend them because he hated political correctness. So go on, trolls, pause and leave a comment saying that's overanalysis. I dare you.
Romeo loved Juliet, Juliet she felt the same. When he put his arms around her, he said, Julie, baby, you're my flame. Now give us fever. When we kiss it, fever with thy flaming youth. Fever, I'm a fire. Fever, yea, I burn forsooth. Captain Smith and Pocahontas had a very mad affair. When a daddy tried to kill him. She said, daddy, oh, don't do that, give me fever.
Good. Now go read the Giger's Alien book and the part where the artist admits the vaginal cross-section metaphor. Number 17. Isn't it weird that they gave Ash white milky blood instead of red blood? So, take your pick from these multiple choice answers about what is going on thematically at the visual level. A. Ash symbolically looks like a baby that's just been born. B. He's just been jazzed on by the alien penis head. C. He's covered in breast milk. Or D. They lost their fake blood recipe on set, so just used cartons of milk that had gone off. Send your answers on a postcard to Free Post, Jimmy the Xenomorph, Nest Number 9, Chamber 11, 7th Planetoid, LV-426. Number 18. How cool is this Egyptian-looking set? Number 19. The chains that hang down here are all moving like the ship is alive, and they provide cover for the hiding alien, which we haven't seen yet in its full-sized form. And there it f***ing is, swinging back and forth. Am I the only person who never noticed it until recently? Number 20. Ever noticed that the floating egg in the poster, with its hills and pockmarks, looks like an egg planet? In the movie, we start with an image of the huge, fleshy alien planet looking like a giant egg, and the Nostromo ship sends a small vessel down to one of its moons in a sort of sperm impregnation of an egg metaphor. See what it says on the screen here? Orbit insertion. And listen to this. Number 21, visit my website collativelearning.com to learn more about learning-related learning. Number 22, what's this mesh stuff at the bottom of the poster? What's it doing there, and what the f*** is it? A giant egg box, or a giant net, or what? Number 23, the surface of LV-426 has organic-looking rock features. For example, these rib things, which Dallas takes a personal interest in. Number 24, the alien ship is like the rotten insides of a dead body. Everything looks like rib cages and wombs and fallopian tubes. The metaphor is a little more obvious in Giger's hieroglyphic design. See how the ship is basically a bent-over humanoid alien figure, with the space jockey room and vaginal entrances in the torso area? Number 25, speaking of the alien hieroglyphics, there's an odd little graphic in the Nostromo ship that might represent the same thing, but upside down. See this blue and red graphic? What the hell is that? It's so specific, and it stands out like a sore thumb. Is there a human lying down with something coming out of their stomach? I don't know, but I do know that we see this design in a scene where Kane is the first one to wake up. After all, he's the one whose chest will be burst open by an alien. And in this similar graphic in another set, there's definitely a human figure. Number 26, ever noticed the Nostromo logo graphic on the crew's uniforms? The planet and moon that we see in it are not the Earth and its moon. Nope. They look more like the planetary system that the crew just visited to pick up an alien. And the logo is surrounded by a rainbow. What the f***? Number 27, like a fetus in a womb, Ash sits in a rotating chair just like the space jockey, and Dallas sits in a similar rotating chair in the womb room. Are these characters basically babies attached to their mother's ship?
You tell me, man, I only work here.
Number 28, ever notice how the Nostromo interior designs are similar to the features of the alien, which allows it to blend in all over the place? The ribbed tubes are quite specific. For some weird reason, there's even one of these tubes in the rocks outside the derelict ship. And about that happy ending? Oh my god, look, there's an alien right next to the hypersleep bed. Number 29, oh my god, it sounds like there's already an alien hiding on the ship before Kane is brought on board. You can hear it here.
What the hell is she coming down here for?
You better stay the fuck out of my way.
I'd like to see what she's going to do when she got there.
Thought sure that was it. Trust me. Feel like I've been in this place a month.
Compare that sound effect with the alien's crying baby noise at the end of the film. Are they f***ing with us or what? Number 30, see this bird wing symbol thing on some of the uniforms and computer equipment? Yeah, I didn't think it was very interesting either. Number 31, see this motion tracker graphic when Dallas is being hunted by the alien? That's sperm and egg stuff, man. Number 32, on LV-426, there's some pretty harsh weather.
Yeah, it's cold, get back in the room, get back in the room.
But for some reason, as soon as the sun comes up, the wind completely stops and the landscape is all peaceful and tranquil. Well, I don't know, you explain it to me. Number 33, did you ever pause the DVD when the facehugger leaps out at Kane and then flick through the sequence frame by frame? I'm not going to show you here on YouTube, but there's a full-on picture of a vagina in there. No joke, I'm deadly serious. Go check your DVD. Number 34, subscribe now or you might miss out on more stupidly awesome future uploads. And number 35, tell lots of people about this video so you've got lots of people to argue with about it. Well, that's it. I'm Rob Ager. Thanks for watching and listening. If my change of tone in this video has offended you, then awesome. But if you like this shit, then get your fucking ass out of your womb comfort zone and head over to my website right now at collativelearning.com, where you can watch and read some of my more sober and academic analysis of classic films. Or at least bookmark the fucking site so you don't forget. Otherwise, get back in your mother's womb until you're ready to open your eyes and wriggle out. Sleep tight and mind the bed bugs don't bite. Thirty-five Reasons Why Alien is an Awesome Horror Porn Birth Death Movie. I've outlined before in my straight-faced analysis videos that Alien plays on the audience's number 5. Wait a minute. If the whole f***ing Nostromo ship is like the organic body of a woman, and the crew are all like babies, all comfy and cozy inside, and are afraid of the cold and hostile universe outside, then does that explain why everybody looks so tired and sleepy so often? And don't believe me? Check out Giga's conceptual designs. See this? That's what the women in the movie are afraid of. Number 2, the central computer on the Nostromo ship is called Mother, and only a motherfucker could miss the symbolism there. Subconscious sexual fears, and our deep desire to return to the comfort and security of the womb. The whole fucking film is packed with details communicating those themes, and more. Here's 35 examples. Number 1, the alien's head is a jack. Number 3, the crew communicate with Mother in a fleshy spherical room with a vaginal door for an exit. Ridley Scott used to call this set the womb room. Number 4, see this acid-proof pen? Parker invented that.